If you think about it, sex is natural, sex is good. Not everybody does it, but everybody should. I genuinely believe, I think sex is a natural part of life that everyone should fulfill. I mean, it's a part of everyone's life.
When you listen to George sound off about sex, you'd swear he'd invented it. Sure, lots of rock and rollers have turned sex into dollars ever since the age of Aquarius. But in the age of AIDS, George Michael has staked his solo career on a heavy embrace of sex. If you are the desert, I'll be the sea. If you ever hunger for me. While his songs and videos are both acclaimed and ridiculed, George is laughing all the way to the bank. At 24, he's a rock millionaire, a huge musical success. And for a lot of young kids, that's part of his attraction.
I'm not going to sit and think, well, they wouldn't, you know, they wouldn't fancy me if I wasn't a pop star, or if I wasn't a singer, or if I wasn't rich, because I am all those things, you know. And that's part of my, that's part of what attracts people to me now.
George laughs all right when he thinks about how it all began with a group called Wham. They camped it up. But millions of kids around the world couldn't wait to join the club. The other half of Wham was George's pal Andrew Ridgely. They were two young men who always seemed out to have fun together. And from the beginning, questions were asked.
George, are you gay?
Am I gay? It's pretty direct first question, isn't it? I've never said no, I've never said yes. No, I'm not. But the main thing I like to express is that I don't think it's anybody's business.
It is a hell of a first question, but when you wrap yourself around sex like George does, when you sing a song called I Want Your Sex, it seems fair enough to ask, what kind of sex do you want?
In other words, what I'm saying is I don't think it benefits anybody listening to my music to know whether or not I was in bed with a dog or a man or a woman last night. You know, it doesn't make any difference.
You know, I generally make jokes about it. You know, in America, I made jokes about it. I mean, from the minute, you know, when they said, are you bisexual? I said, yeah, when I want sex, I have to buy it. You know, are you homosexual? Yeah, I have sex at home, you know.
The gay talk started up again recently when that other George of British pop, Boy George, said George Michael was gay. The friendship between the two Georges was suddenly over.
I remember the first time I ever met Boy George, the first thing he said to me was, you're so straight, you must be gay. So I thought, fine. And I've never said anything, I've always just accepted that he thinks, that he might think I'm gay, probably thinks most of the world is gay. I think it's a shame that he had a snipe at me, because I've always quite liked him, I've always admired his strength of character, but I don't really call what he's been doing lately strength of character.
So you're really a bit upset that he said you were gay?
Just disappointed. No, I wasn't upset that he said I was gay. That was not... I mean, I've had enough people, you know, accuse me of various things. I've even been accused of bestiality, apparently, by one paper, which is quite alarming in a sense. Wake me up
before you go, go. Wham was hounded by bizarre publicity, even in their most innocent, clean-cut days. But when George and Andrew hit the London club scene, Fleet Street painted them as a pair of bad boys.
Some of those Fleet Street headlines.
Mm-hmm.
George Michael throws up over blonde.
Mm-hmm. Still in court, that one.
Fact or fiction?
What's in court? I don't know if I'm even allowed to say that it's fact. Of course it's fiction.
Story number two, George Michael dancing around with a bottle full of pills, poppers.
That was good.
True or false, though?
Oh, false. They said something about... It said, George came back to the club at least 20 times, and each time with a bigger bottle. You know, I had this vision of me like running into the club with this 2-litre bottle of amyl nitrate. It was just pathetic.
Do you use cocaine?
No, I never touch cocaine. I hate coke. I hate the people that deal coke. I hate what goes on around coke. I think it's it's not just a rock and roll thing now, it's a total yuppie thing, and it disgusts me. I just think it's horrible. But the thing is, apart from anything else, I don't think I look like someone who's been doing 5 years of drugs.
Fresh-faced, drug-free, you couldn't get a cleaner package than Wham. George and Andy took the kids to play school, where there was only one lesson, how to have fun. But when George looks back at Wham, even he admits some of this is embarrassing.
Yeah, I'm very embarrassed about some of them. I'm proud of most of the stuff that Wham did musically, but from the point of view of image, there's an awful lot of stuff going on which, given the chance to do it again, I would maybe change. Everyone was pretty camp around that time. I mean, 1983, 1984 was not the most butch period in rock and roll, you know? And there are definitely videos that make me really cringe.
After 4 years on the road together, the bubblegum bubble burst. George split with Andy. Wham was no more.
4 years, millions of dollars, millions of records sold. Why did you finally say slam bam, goodbye, Wham?
Well, it was simply because it was not fun anymore. Because we were growing up, we weren't kids anymore. We couldn't have that, we couldn't genuinely promote that totally carefree thing anymore. But it wasn't a matter of wanting to dump Andrew or anything, because we started it together and we wanted to finish it together. You know, I always knew that I would have a solo career, and so did he. It was just a matter of how long Wham would remain fun for us. Tonight the music seems so loud.
I wish that we could lose this crowd. While other pretty faces have fallen from the charts, George Michael has made it to the top. He's bigger now as a solo performer than he was with Wham.
Why do you think so many young girls are attracted to you?
I wouldn't know. If I knew that, then maybe I'd bottle it.
Even before we began our chat, George spent almost an hour on makeup and hair. Image is so important to him, he'd only let us film the left side of his face.
This is still me, George Michael, performer to a degree, because I'm on camera and everyone on camera, you know, we wouldn't sit here talking in the same manner if we were just sitting here with a couple of drinks or whatever.
Filming your best side, like we're doing.
Absolutely.
Is that part of George Michael, a performer?
Well, George Michael, a performer, picks his photos, knows his best side. George Michael, the performer, has been watching every little detail of the last 5 years very carefully.
George knows what he's got and how to sell it. I Want Your Sex, the song, the video, the controversial message, has brought all the publicity he needs to push his solo career. Just to make sure, the man who wouldn't let us film the right side of his face has turned the other cheek. Call it video art or softcore porn. But you won't stop George Michael peddling sex to his young fans, no matter how much it upsets their parents.
If you were a parent, is that possible?
Huh? Is it possible I'm a parent? It's possible, very remotely possible, but it's possible.
One day in the future?
Well, Jack, this is asking for trouble. You'll probably have five or six people rush to Fleet Street now. No, in the future it's possible, yeah.
If you were a parent, would you like your daughter to sit there watching a video with George Michael's naked butt?
I've never had my naked butt. No. Yes, I have, actually, kind of half of it. I certainly wouldn't object. I don't think there's anything I've done that's even vaguely pornographic.
In Britain, they banned it. George's striptease was too much for the BBC. But the joke is, it's not even Gorgeous George's bottom.
Whose butt is it that we're seeing in the video?
No, mum's the word. There's a bit, no, it depends which version you've seen, really. There's various butts in there.
To the people who won't play I Want Your Sex, it's a call for promiscuity among kids at a dangerous time. But George insists he's highly aware of the danger of AIDS and that what you're watching is really a call for an end to promiscuity.
It doesn't sound, though, like a campaign against promiscuity when the verse goes, sex is natural, sex is good. Mm. Not everybody does it, but everybody should.
It's true. I think it's true. I mean, do you know how many people have you met in your life that you think are better for not having sex? I didn't say have it now or have it when you're 12 or have it when you're 14. I said everybody should have sex.
But what makes you think that the world needs telling? That really, because, they should go out there and make love.
Because everything is pointing in the other direction. People are calling sex something dirty, something dangerous.
Many people, though, completely contrary to what you're saying, find that in the age of AIDS, your song is irresponsible because...
No, it's because they... I mean, if you ask kids who've heard both sides of the argument, right, and they did, right, it's not kids that are accusing me of that. It's kids' parents. Or it's people in media who are older or whatever.
Let's do it. It's logical, habitual.
Well, you make up your mind. Is George for real about saving kids from AIDS? Or is it a lot of screeching about things that are better whispered?
Sex is natural, sex is good. Not everybody does it, but everybody should.
I've listened to a lot of rock and roll, but I honestly can't think of, really, a more tasteless verse than sex is natural, sex is good, not everybody does it, but everybody should. I mean, that would rank really as one of the most banal and trite three lines in rock and roll.
How I don't think it's trite. It's definitely an outstanding pop lyric. It's definitely going to be there in 5-10 years time.
To go down with Wake Me Up Before You
Probably
Go-Go?
To go down with Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go, yeah, and I'm very proud of both of them.
Hello, I'm Liz Hayes. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9 Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.